In the early 1980s, Japan's government set out to bolster its domestic aviation industry by developing a new fighter aircraft from scratch. What followed was a complex decade of negotiations with the United States, resulting in a unique compromise, a Japanese-built variant of the F-16 produced by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries. Designated the F-2, this aircraft has since become a cornerstone of the Japan Air Self-Defense Force, blending American design with Japanese innovation. By the late 1970s, the Japanese Self-Defense Force needed a modern fighter to replace aging types like the Starfighter and Phantom II. Japan already operated US designs, many built under license, but its long-term goal was to revive a fully independent aviation industry, echoing its World War II prowess with aircraft like Mitsubishi's Zero. The plan was to design a new fighter from the ground up, led by Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, a company with a proven track record in military aviation. Later dubbed FSX, Fighter Support Experimental, by the Americans, the project aimed for a clean-sheet design. However, by the mid-1980s, tensions arose with the United States. US officials worried that a purely Japanese fighter might weaken their defense partnership if it underperformed, or conversely, compete with American industry if it excelled. Japan, meanwhile, resisted simply buying off-the-shelf US jets, prioritizing domestic production. After years of debate, a deal was struck in late 1988. Instead of a new aircraft, Japan and the US agreed to co-develop a derivative of the F-16 with General Dynamics, later Lockheed Martin, as the American partner. Japan would fund roughly 60% of the program, with Mitsubishi overseeing development and assembly. The FSX project was born, though it came with controversy. In the US, some feared it handed Japan too much technology. In Japan, critics saw it as a one-sided deal, granting the US Department of Defense access to Japanese innovations while locking Japan into American patents. One Japanese lawmaker claimed that the deal exemplified how Japan gives away all of its most advanced technology to America, yet Japan has to pay patent on each piece of technology it uses. Costs didn't help the optics either. The F-2's price tag, driven by development and higher per unit production, far exceeded that of a standard F-16 Block 50, a point of contention on both sides of the Pacific. Nevertheless, the FSX program kicked off in March 1990. Mitsubishi took the lead, handling about 45% of development, while US firms contributed key components and expertise. The resulting F-2 shares the F-16's silhouette, but diverges in critical ways, tailored to Japan's needs. Unlike the standard F-16, optimized for diverse air-to-ground roles, the F-2 was designed with Japan's environment in mind, focused on air-to-air and maritime strike missions over the Pacific. General Dynamics provided a starting point, the Agile Falcon, a concept from the late 1980s Advanced Tactical Fighter Competition to compete against the YF-22 and 23. Though never built, the Agile Falcon proposed a larger F-16 with enhanced capabilities, influencing the F-2's design. The F-2 grew accordingly, a 25% larger wing area, a bigger tailplane, and an extended nose. Composite materials lightened the airframe and reduced radar cross-section, while a drogue parachute aided landings on Japan's shorter runways. The F-2's 11 hardpoints, two more than the F-16's typical 9, offered greater flexibility for weapons and fuel. Inside, the cockpit swapped the F-16's clean single-screen layout for a three-piece display, giving pilots a busier but versatile interface. The original active electronically scanned array radar, the JAPG-1, was the first of its kind on an operational fighter when the F-2 debuted. Later upgrades brought the JAPG-2, but in 1995, the JAPG-1 gave it an edge over contemporaries. Collaboration on the project was extensive. Mitsubishi built the forward fuselage and wings, Kawasaki supplied the midsection and gear doors, and Lockheed Martin delivered aft fuselages, slats, and wing boxes. Raytheon and Kokusai Electric handled communications and IFF systems, while Honeywell and Japan Aviation Electric co-developed the fly-by-wire controls. Final assembly took place in Nagoya, overseen by Mitsubishi, with the first F-2 flying on October 7, 1995. Testing proved successful, and Japan initially ordered 141 airframes. Budget constraints trimmed this to 130, then 94 by program's end. The first prototype arrived in March 1996, followed by a formal US-Japan Memorandum of Understanding in July. Production aircraft began delivery in September 2000, with the last rolling out in September 2011. Nicknamed the Viper Zero, a nod to its F-16 roots and Mitsubishi's Zero legacy, the F-2 entered Japanese service as a multi-role workhorse. At twice the cost of an F-16 Block 50 and 52, it brought distinct advantages. The JAPG-1 ASA radar was a first in 1995, paired with low observable composites for a stealthier profile. Its larger airframe held more fuel and weapons, yet kept pace with the F-16's top speed of Mach 2.0. The F-2's service ceiling reaches 18,000 meters, 59,055 feet, topping the F-16 C Block 40's 15,240 meters, 50,000 feet. Its combat radius stretches to just over 800 kilometers compared to the Block 50's 550 kilometers, ideal for Japan's maritime focus, though Mitsubishi notes it's optimized for shorter range missions and would retain a Mach 2.0 maximum speed at altitude. Empty weight is 9,527 kilograms, 21,000 pounds, only about 1,000 kilograms more than the Block 50 and 52's 8,573 kilograms, 18,900 pounds. The array of armament also made the F-2 unique when compared to the F-16. Alongside US-made AIM-120 AMRAAMs and AIM-9 Sidewinders, it carries Mitsubishi's AAM-4 air-to-air missile. The ASM-1 and ASM-2 anti-ship missiles, plus AGM-65 Maverick compatibility, make it a potent maritime striker. With 11 hardpoints, it can carry 8 air-to-air missiles plus all 3 drop tanks and pods mounted on fuselage left and right mounting points. Or alternatively, 6 air-to-air missiles, drop tanks, and a spare 2 pylon for other weapons, or perhaps 6 air-to-air missiles, the centerline drop tank, and 4 hardpoints. Just like the standard Viper, the F-2 can hypothetically be set up with expansions for each of the 4 inner wing pylons to maximize payload, such as the BRU-57 double rack for GPS-guided GBUs, or the old triple ejector rack for standard bombs. All in all, the F-2, like the F-16, has the hypothetical capability of carrying a huge payload on a rather small airframe. Since its debut, some have claimed the Mitsubishi F-2 stands as the finest F-16 variant ever produced, a debate open to scrutiny given its cost and scope. Regardless, its value to the Japan Air Self-Defense Force is undeniable, a linchpin in Japan's modern air fleet. Should Japan face conflict again, it would likely involve a regional foe, with battles spanning dense terrain and vast ocean expanses. This demands a mix of air superiority fighters and agile multi-role platforms. Historically, Japan relied on the F-104J from 1962 to 1986 for interception, then the F-4EJ from 1972 to 2020 for mixed roles. In 1981, the F-15J, a twin-seat evolution of the F-15C Eagle, joined the roster, excelling in air dominance. The F-2 complements it, offering a lightweight, versatile package with strong all-around performance. Introduced in 2000, it has proven essential. Its 11 hardpoints and maritime strike capabilities pairing effectively with the F-15J's reach to counter regional threats, notably China's advancing aircraft. As of 2025, the F-2's role ensures it will remain operational well into the future. Mitsubishi Heavy Industries, often under-recognized, carries a storied legacy. From the A6M0 to today, the F-2 upholds this tradition, enhancing the F-16's proven design with Japan-specific refinements. For the Japanese Self-Defense Force, it's a tailored triumph, blending US technology with Japanese precision to meet exacting defense needs.